Alrighty, so we're just going to jump right into it, and here we go. So, traveling with pets, why do introverts like it, right? So today, we wanted to talk about taking your pets with you when you travel. We did this for the first time when we went to Augusta, Georgia recently, and we have an Australian Blue Heeler mix, and her name is Chloe. And it was great to have her with us when we visited this new place. Why? Well, for the same reason we like to take our pillows when we sleep in a different place. It's like taking a piece of home with us when we go. So there's some challenges that we discovered when traveling with our puppy, though, and we're going to talk about those next. So, the first challenge that we faced that we had to sort of get through was bathroom breaks. So Chloe's getting a little older, so she needs a bathroom break about every 2 hours or so. So that means we have to stop and find a place for her to do that. Typically, you can find designated places for your animals at rest stops or gas stations, but not always. So in that case, you know, just be respectful and try to find a spot. And, you know, police your puppy do. Let's see. This challenge number two that we found was finding a place to eat. Now, this one's kind of interesting because there's usually always going to be at least two places that have where you have the ability to eat with your animal outside, right? But they're not always like the best places, or they're not like I had an idea where I wanted to go. I thought that this one place would be great, and it turned out that we could not go there because they had no outdoor seating so that we could sit with her. So I had to scrap that idea and do something else. So that can happen with it. If it's the weather is inclement, so if it's raining, you know, you're not going to be going out to eat with your animal. We had to do a bit of research before going, just, you know, find a place. Now, one scenario we ran into in Augusta was Chloe and I ended up sitting outside while Brendan went in to order the food and bring the drinks out and, you know, bring the food out. So depending on where you go, you might have to divide and conquer on that level, so. The third challenge, and really this one, this one's more just, was like annoying because she just got so excited, and it's not really so much of a challenge, but many times trying to take pictures and have her on the leash and walk her at the same time was a challenge because we would be trying to take the picture, and she would be fine, nice and calm. All of a sudden, squirrel! Boom! She is at the end of her leash, she's half pulled me, you know. And my picture was going to be this beautiful landscape, and now it's a blur. So, there's that challenge as well. So, that can be overcome with training, though, and I've just been really bad about that. So, it just sort of depends. So these are not hard things to overcome. It's just things to keep in mind when you travel with a doggy. So we made checklists sort of help us whenever we were traveling with her. It might help you too if you think about it whenever you go. So one is always, always, always take their leash, right? Because every place, it doesn't seem to matter where we go. There's either time frames where they have to be on leash, or there's just always on leash, and you can't leave that behind. Doggy do bags. You have to pick up after your dog no matter where you go. It's not only is it the polite and nice thing to do, it's against the law in many places, and you can have your dog taken from you or go to jail. I've seen stuff like that. So papers. Any and all vaccine papers that you could have for them. But especially rabies. Dogs get put down if there's a bite, whether they bite another dog or they bite a person. And you can't prove they're vaccinated for it, so you don't want that. Food and water bowl. Okay, so that seems really obvious, but we almost forgot it the first time. I don't know what I was thinking, but, you know, I wasn't doing my checklist. And the checklists are important when you travel, so you know you have everything you need. So, toys. Now, Chloe doesn't have any toys. She doesn't really play that way. She likes to run and like wrangle things because of her breed. So she doesn't have toys, but if you have a dog or you have a cat that loves a certain toy, you should take it with them. That way they can acclimate to the new area. So that's just a suggested list for doggies. You definitely need to know your animal. You need to understand what they can handle and what they can't. And we started with her taking her places a little bit at a time. Like we went 30 minutes away, then we went an hour away, and then I think Augusta's like 2.5 hours away. So just so we could get used to it, and she could get used to it, we could understand what we would need to do, and how often she'd need to stop, and what she would need, etc. like that. So there's those things you have to consider too, is maybe your dog wouldn't like to travel. I have an uncle and he has two dogs. One dog sits up front with him in his truck and acts like a person. He watches the cars go by, he watches the people go by, and he just sits there and just watches stuff go by and he thinks it's awesome. His other dog, not even putting this other dog into the vehicle, she becomes so scared that she pees herself. So, know your animal. Some animals, traveling is not a thing that they can do. So you might, if you know you're going to be a certain type of traveler, want to look into certain kinds of breeds that can do that with you. Now, we haven't traveled with our cats because we don't like being, because they don't like being in a car at all, unless it's stationary. And even then, they only like to go in to sleep. So I can imagine though that the biggest challenge with taking a cat with you is like a litter box and giving them a place to observe the territory of the car or the room you're going to be staying in. So here's some ideas for those challenges. So a litter box. What we actually ended up doing for just the house, even when they were inside, is we actually bought under bed storage plastic containers because they're larger. They're not very deep, a lot of them, they're only like this deep, but it's enough for the cat to go, and then it has a lid so you can secure it and pick it up or move it or put it wherever it is you need to go, and that way you're not smelling it either, that kind of thing. So, another one, maybe for the observation station where they can sit and enjoy themselves and feel like they are the king in their castle there. So maybe take a pillow that they use at the house or their bed, if they have a bed, and place it on the dash. I've seen people do that. Or in the back seat where they can remain secure for the whole trip. I've seen many people use those mesh sort of soft box carriers so the cat can still see what's happening but also be secured in this with the seatbelt. So there's also that. I would like to take my cats, but I don't think that they would go with us. I'm pretty sure. I know I have two, Baby and Courage, and I know Baby would hate it. She doesn't even like being inside the house, so. But Courage might be okay with it. He's pretty courageous. That's why his name is Courage. He doesn't have any problem doing most things, and if he doesn't like it, he tells you immediately. So there's that. That's all I have for today, guys. If you have any comments or suggestions, or you've traveled with animals before, and you can tell me a cool story, that would be awesome. So I'm gonna go to chat here. I do have a couple of things. Let's see. George. Hey, George. I don't know if you're still here, but hello. And Amy, Miss Simmons joined. So hello, Amy. So anyway, that's it for us today. I just wanted to talk about that. We did not take Chloe for the longest time just because I didn't know how to do it. I was like, I don't even know if this dog would do this with me, or if she would throw up, or what. So that's something else to consider too. I'd just be like, well, I'm just gonna toss her in there and see how it goes. And it worked wonderfully. She loved doing it, so we were really lucky as far as that goes. How many of you guys travel with an animal? Let me know in the comments. All right, guys, until next week, I'll see you then. Bye.